fast. Lowered airspeed.
Strider 1, you have passed through waypoint 1. No weapons until you reach the enemy base. All aircraft, reduce altitude. We have altitude restrictions from here on out. Keep altitude below 600 meters.
Caution. Pull
good.
Up.
Maintain your current course.
Caution. Pull up. Caution. Pull up. Caution. Pull up.
Searchlight up ahead. Watch for it.
Stay out of their sight.
Strider, Nazareth 1. Our current ETA matches yours. Catch them off guard. Can we secure the LZ quickly?
We'll get you down safe. I'm worried you're short on men.
Caution. Pull up.
Everyone here's already signed their wounds.
That ain't funny.
Never was good at jokes.
Caution.
Okay.
Pull up.
Falling with it.
Caution.
Fuck.
Pull up.
Understood.
Caution. Pull up. Caution. Pull up. Caution. Caution. Pull up.
Strider 1, you've passed through waypoint 2. The valley's about to get narrower. Be careful.
When can we take on the final mission? I'm starting to get tired of all this.
This is the last step, Count. We'll take the enemy base and use it as a bridgehead.
Watch yourselves out there. We're going to need all of you in Far Bounty. Without Wiseman here, everybody wants to give orders like they're the company commander himself. And the best thing about Strider Squadron is our leader keeps his mouth shut.
Waypoint 3. You're coming up on the base. Imposing radio silence. We won't be able to talk again until you're over the base. Continue to keep an eye on your altitude. There are plenty of dark spots that can sneak up on you.
Caution. Pull up. Caution. Caution. Caution.
Point 4. Radio silence has been lifted. You're almost at the base.
We made it. That was quite the roller coaster ride. Visual confirmation on the airbase. Reach destination.
Commence the attack. It's time for their wake-up call. The longer it takes, the worse off we'll be. Hurry up. Finish them off.
All right, let's give them a beating.
Two remaining.
Vehicle.
reinforcements. Get some goddamn support there now.
Enemy numbers are small. Don't give in. Fight until the very end.
Strider One. Strider One has landed. Let's go and greet him.
Strider One, you have passed through waypoint one.
Excellent work on the night raid. Submarines have arrived from the Ocean mainland and are refueling. This base will serve as a frontline platform for our mission to take Farbanti. We're almost at the end of this operation.
Mihai's second sortie was designed to calculate how his physiology changed under the stress of combat. My job was to compare his performance as a pilot now to when he was younger and understand how his skills evolved. To tell you the truth, I'm not sure I wanted to know the answers anymore. For a man his age, Mihai's body was unbelievably resilient, remarkably flexible. His reflexes were as sharp as they ever were. Still, after all those years of flying in the outer layers of the atmosphere, even someone as strong as Mihai wasn't immune to the effects of the strain. The human body is fragile. It was not meant to handle the excessive amounts of radiation that constantly bombarded the stratosphere. For Mihai's second sortie, we used a flight suit that was still untested. He seemed fine on takeoff, but by the time he landed back at the base, he was clearly a mess. He got caught in a surprise dogfight with an especially stubborn enemy. It took a while for Mihai to bring him down.
Suspend mission.
The suit was ineffective. According to the data, it wouldn't let him fly to his full potential. A new flight suit was made to my exact specifications. When it finally arrived, Mihai's granddaughters glared at me with their disapproval. They blamed me for the pain their grandfather had to keep enduring. But Mihai remained stoic. He wasn't the type of man who cared about anything that happened here on the ground. I wasn't worried about it. I was confident the new suit would protect him thoroughly so that he could maneuver his plane any way he wanted. The moment he took off in his new flight suit, I realized what I had failed to before. Right after takeoff, as the wheels retracted, the plane suddenly arced up. It accelerated so quickly. I had never seen a plane move like that before. Mihai hit the high G's multiple times before disappearing into the blue. The support team couldn't even keep up. And then I knew. I understood why he never seemed to care about restoring his stolen country back to its former glory, and why he didn't seem to care about anything that happened here on the ground. Of course, Mihai's kingdom was the sky.
The operation to capture Arusha's capital, Farbanti, is beginning. This is the culmination of our work. We need to capture the Arusian forces' general headquarters in the south of Farbanti and end this war. The plan is for ground troops to attack Farbanti from both the east and north, and a task fleet will attack from the southwest. We will secure air superiority over the capital while providing air support for our allies on the ground and in the water as required. By all accounts, we expect this to be an intense, full-scale battle across land, sea, and air. Should you need to replenish your ammunition or make necessary repairs to your craft, a return line has been set up in the north. During this operation, we will also be tasked with having to destroy the communications satellites that Arusha hacked. If we take down the information communications system we believe they have control over. It should plunge Arusha into chaos. Once the capital falls, the Arusian military will be isolated and thrown into chaos, making it easier for us to end the war. However, that can't happen until after the capital falls, so you guys are the stars of this battle. Arusha will fight like a tiger, but we cannot lose. We must seize the capital and end this war.
Squadron, proceed to runway. Sortie ASAP. Our troops.
Episode 14. I hope you enjoyed. Hope you have a great night, and we'll catch you on the next one.